It's no wonder that so many people who struggle financially also struggle with their weight. They require such similar skills and tactics. What's interesting is that once you master losing weight or budgeting your money, it doesn't matter which one. It really is not as difficult to master the other. Is it easy? No. Is it fun? Well, once you start making headway, it can be, but overall, the whole process sucks. But by applying the same tactics you use to get your finances in order, you can really also succeed in a weight loss journey. Using myself as an example, as I always do, my husband and I have recently paid off over $200,000 worth of debt simply by budgeting our money. And about 5 years ago, I lost around 75 pounds. And over the last few months, I've lost another 25 or so. And while I'm not yet at my goal weight, nor am I at my financial goal, I've noticed some very, very distinct similarities in both processes, whichever one you want to pronounce. Hi, I'm Wendy Valencia. Here in the Valencia household, we believe that I am going to get eaten alive by mosquitoes.
Hi. And it's Melina Valencia, and we spent a lot of money on this furry backpack and a furry pencil case. So never spend too much money when you don't want to.
Well, we had it planned in the budget, so it was perfectly okay, right?
Yeah, but if you don't have it planned in the budget, don't buy anything because that's bad.
Yeah.
You'll spend all your money and that's gonna go down in a road you never wanna be in.
Yep, good job. Hi, I'm Wendy Valencia. Here in the Valencia household, we believe you can organize your way to success in any goal you are trying to achieve. Yes, organization will get you to your goals. I have been hyper-organized for my entire adult life, and while I've been budgeting for a decade, we were just kind of getting by. We were doing okay financially, but we were not really succeeding. We weren't failing, but we weren't succeeding. It wasn't until I really organized our finances and started tracking our spending down to the penny that we really started to succeed. And in the last 3 years, as I said before, we paid off over $200,000 worth in debt. We've gotten one full month ahead in our finances, which means what we earn this month goes to pay next month's bills. We've got 9 different savings accounts, which we are using to save for things coming down the pike. And we're also saving to buy this house. So as I've said, I've also lost a lot of weight and managed to keep it off. So when I tell you that losing weight and budgeting are similar, I know of what I speak. So these are the observations I've made. And what I've discovered is that once you have success in one area, like getting your finances in order, it's really kind of easy to succeed in other areas because you find yourself thinking things like, well, I paid off $200,000 worth of debt, so most certainly I can lose 30 pounds. So let's get into it. The first way that budgeting and weight loss are similar is you have to want to succeed. This is probably the key to success in both weight loss and budgeting. Mindset when you're starting out is so incredibly important. You have to convince yourself that failure is not an option, that if you are going to succeed, you are going to succeed at all costs. That excitement will get you through those first few hard months when you're not really seeing any progress. The second way that budgeting and weight loss are similar is if you're too restrictive, you're most likely to binge. Y'all have seen this with my budgets for sure. That's why you'll never see me do a no spend, unless of course the government forces me to do one. Because they do. The safest way to reach financial weight loss goals is to go slowly, cutting back on a lot, but not everything, trying to leave yourself not feeling deprived. The third way budgeting and weight loss are similar is that you have to have a plan, and your plan needs to be super specific. My money and weight loss plans rarely involve a specific number by a specific date unless there is some sort of looming deadline. Because if I don't meet that number, there's a possibility of frustration, and Frustration can lead to failure. So what we try and do is set smaller, achievable goals so we're constantly succeeding. So for example, a goal for finances that we are doing for the next 6 months is that we're going to try and put a minimum of $2,000 towards debt and save $2,000. A goal for weight loss might be for 1 month, I will keep my calorie intake below 1,400 calories, or I will maybe make sure that I track every single thing that goes into my mouth for an entire month. Which leads me to number four. The fourth way that weight loss and budgeting are similar is that you have to write things down. I think by now you understand that financial success is difficult without a budget. Sure, it can be done, but if you're like us, you have a million little expenses that can add up to a huge amount of money. And if you're not writing down every single cent, you're kind of likely to piddle away any extra money you have. The same is true for calories. I can't tell you how many calories I consume standing at the stove while I'm like prepping dinner. Actually, I can tell you pretty closely because I do write everything down. And it's a couple hundred calories. And that leads me to number five. The fifth way that losing weight and budgeting your money are similar is that you need to keep a cushion. You know, I have a cushion of about $200 a month in my budget, which keeps us from going over budget because I talk about it every single month. There are little overages that we don't plan on. Well, I actually have those for calories too. I set my meal plan for the day about 300 calories lower than I actually want to consume. That way, if I take a bite of Melina's quesadilla while I'm cleaning off her plate, not that I would ever do that for real, I'm still on my plan because, to be honest, I'm going to take a bite of that food or I'm going to taste the food that I'm making for dinner. So let's go ahead and plan for it. The sixth way that budgeting and weight loss are similar is that reconciling is vital to success. I cannot emphasize this enough. You know I believe this with budgeting, but did you know I believe it with weight loss too? As I said in number four, you have to track both your budget and your food intake. For me, I track my food intake much in the same way I budget. I make a plan and write it all down, and then I make changes as I need to. You see me moving calories around during the day in the exact same way I move money around. The seventh way that losing weight and budgeting your money are similar is that you kind of need to use a zero-based budget for both. You shouldn't spend money you don't have, and you shouldn't overeat. Doing both, I'm getting attacked by bugs. Doing both will send you into a deficit. And with money, it means debt. And with food, it means gaining weight. So we all know that the zero-based budget for money means that you plan for every cent of your income, making sure that you have allocated every cent somewhere. What's left over is zero. Well, the same is true for calories. If you think of your calorie plan for the day and plan out every calorie and stop when you hit zero, you'll be operating on a zero-based food budget. Makes sense, right? The eighth way that losing weight and budgeting your money are similar is that you can't make anybody do it if they don't want to. Getting your spouse on board budgeting can be a daunting task. And if you think that's hard, try and get him to give up Sonic or Honey Buns when they don't want to. Trust me, I've tried. It isn't fun. I could do a whole video on how to get your spouse on board with your plan because it's a whole lesson in patience and good timing. The ninth way budgeting and weight loss are similar, you will have hardcore periods and you will have periods when you're just getting by. But if you do this long enough, you will see that there are times when you're able to kill it and then there are other times when you're going to struggle. And if you accept that your enthusiasm will wax and wane and relax a little when it's waning, you'll be far more likely to make it to the end of the race. I had a 4-year period after losing 75 pounds where I just maintained my weight loss. That was good. I didn't have the enthusiasm to lose the last portion, but my enthusiasm came back. Now that I've been at it for 3 months, I can see my enthusiasm starting to die down again. I'm trying to stoke the fire a little bit to see if the enthusiasm comes back. But if it doesn't, I may take off a year or two and just work on maintaining my weight loss before hitting it hard again. In about 2 years, Mauricio and I will be entering a time of difficulty with our finances where we will just be surviving. And that will be totally okay because you can't kill it all the time. And that leads us into number 10. The 10th way losing weight and budgeting your money are so similar is that slow and steady is the best way to have long-term success. The goal is to change your behaviors, and you change your behavior by repetition over time. Doing the same thing over and over, month after month, solidifies it in your brain. I budget every month, and I will always budget because it's a habit. I've been doing it for 10 years. I'm used to it. The same is true for eating healthy. It's just a habit now. The 11th way that losing weight and budgeting your money are so similar is because it's only $20 and it's only 100 calories mean the exact same thing. Basically, it means you're trying to justify your expenditure and you're gonna end up going off plan in small repeated amounts. I know I've said it before, those $20 and those 100 calories really add up quickly. So when you hear yourself saying it's only dot, 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 as in it's only one bite, those onlys can add up really quickly, which really transitions well into number 12. The only person that suffers from overspending and overeating is you. Your overspending and your overeating won't impact your neighbors or your coworkers. Only you, and maybe when talking about money, your family will be impacted by your bad choices. When I weighed a lot more than I do today, I used to binge the night before I started out a new diet. I totally pig out. But I learned that if I gain 5 pounds the week before I start a new diet, I'm just gonna have to lose it. I certainly wouldn't wanna go out and charge $1,000 worth of stuff because I decided to pay off all my debt, would I? When you look at it like that, it really does seem asinine that you would do that. The 13th reason that budgeting your money and losing weight are so similar is that you need to plan and save for splurges. In money, it's obvious. That's why we have sinking funds. And granted, all our sinking funds are not for splurges. Some of them are just common good sense. And while it's impossible to have a diet sinking fund, you can look and see what's coming down the pike. If you see that there's like a big party on Saturday and you know the food's gonna be awesome, then maybe eat 100 less calories every day the week before the party is a good way to navigate eating what you want and still enjoying yourself. So I'll see you in the next one. See ya. We're out.